Welcome to module 19. So now we will discuss a typical construction, a typical SDR, okay, strong differential track, from which you can construct almost all well-known deformation tracks. As such, there are not many ways of even constructing homotopies. But they all fall into a certain pattern. Okay, almost always things are happening in the domain itself. Okay, so there are that kind of consideration is what I am going to do now. Okay. The construction of a typical strong deformation track. So all these things will carry out, first of all, in I cross I. Okay, then slowly we will make it slightly little complicated, but that's it. After that, that can be used with the slightly modifications and so on in many situations. So what I do in I cross I take the x-axis part, and on the y-axis I take 1 cross I. Okay, you put two, the other two also. So instead of the entire boundary, I'm taking two of the sides, not opposite, adjacent sides. So I cross 0 and 1 cross I. Then this subspace is a strong deformation retract of I cross I. So like Sagnik says, it will be intuitively clear. But that is not where we live. We will write down a specific strong deformation retract. Even to do that, there are many ways to do it. So what I am going to tell you is a geometric way of doing this, and this can be generalized to construct many things. Okay, so here is it is. What do I do? In I cross I have chosen this I cross 0 and 1 cross I. This is my subspace. Okay, I want to get a strong deformation retract of the entire square onto the subspace A. So what I do? I take some point on the y-axis above this square somewhere. So here, for suitability, I have chosen 0, 2. That's not neat. I could have chosen this point or far away 0, 200 also, no problem. From that point, I am taking a view of the whole thing. Okay, so first I see this one, right, from here. Then I can just keep, you know, if this is a transparent thing, my eyes will see all the way to bottom here. So this line will tell me what I should do. So take a point here. I am going to push this point slowly to this point. This entire line 0, 0 to 0, 1, namely 0 cross I, is going to push down to this point. Okay, then a point here will go in here. This point will go to this point. Okay, so this is one part. You will have one single formula for this much. But when you want further, for example, a point here, will you go into this point here, namely on the 1 cross I, the y-axis part, okay, this line. But then the formula will be different. Okay, we have seen that, right? So I am going to push this one, this portion here. This point remains here, of course. There's nothing to push there. So this way, pushing means what? You do it at time t, at time zero, it is identity, nothing has happened. At time t, say t prime, this part has already pushed up to here. This point has come here, 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 and so on. Only this much is left out. To keep doing it at time equal to one, t equal to one, only this segment and this segment will remain. So that is the homotopy. During this homotopy, points of A don't move. They are there. Okay? Therefore, it's a strong deformation right track. So this is geometry proof. After this, many books stop here. They don't write down. It is writing down is just for your sake. Namely, you get more confident. So I have done that. You can write down yourself, but you may not know how to write down such a thing. So these are just actually linear projections. So it is linear algebra. Okay. So I have explained what it is. Namely, P is 0, comma 2. You have to parameterize. Take a point here. Parameterize this portion from here to here, this portion, this line segment. Write down parameterization for this line. Use that parameterization as a homotopy from this point to this point. At t equal to 0, it should be this point. At t equal to 1, it should be that. You have to write a continuous way for saying one formula up to here, from here to this point. Can you write down the coordinates of this point? What is this point? This point is the intersection of this horizontal line here and the line joining 0 to 1, 0. So you can write down. So it's just plain coordinate geometry. Okay. So that's precisely what I have done here. Okay. The map pushes the point arbitrary z, whatever z, to rz. Okay. rz is a retract at the end. The end result here. Okay, any z here comes to rz. The tip of the arrow will be the rz. Point here will come here. Point here will also come here. That is rz. Okay. The student of topology is expected to appreciate this as a final proof, and others are expected to swallow it in good faith. This is the way many books explain it, maximum explanation. They just go away out. Okay. So if you want to feel that, if you want to do this kind of things on your own in a different situation, what is the way to learn? You have to, this is an easy method. Here you have to be very sure that you can write down the formula. So you have to write down. Okay. So let me go through this for a while. I'm doing it just for you. Let us prepare ourselves by working out a few such ideas into proofs so that we can appreciate such ideas as proofs later in many other situations. This is my contention. Of course, very first thing to verify is that the map z going to rz is continuous. To see this, we divide the square I cross I into two parts by the line joining 1 comma 0 to 0 comma 2. That's what I told you, right? Where is it? 1 comma 0 to this 0 comma 2. So this is one quadrilateral, that's a triangle. So it's divided into two parts like that. So one formula of R is this one. It pushes everything to x-axis. The other formula pushes it to this y-axis at, namely, 1 cross i. Okay, so here I have two different formulas. If z equal to tt prime is in the lower part, okay, namely, t prime is less than equal to twice 1 minus 2, 1 minus t. Then rz is this, given by this formula. On the other hand, if t prime is bigger than equal to 2 into 1 minus t, and r z is this one. The first coordinate here is something, the second coordinate is 0, so it's on the x-axis. Here the first coordinate is 1, second coordinate is 1. Why this equality, inequality, these inequalities give you the two divisions. This one will give you what I told you as the quadrilateral, this one gives you the triangle there. So on the line, on that line itself, both these formulas will agree, namely the entire line goes to 1 comma 0. Therefore, this is a continuous function. After that, homotopy between identity and R is just easy, namely it is 1 minus S or T double prime Z plus T double prime term R. In the case of, now you can appreciate why I did it for the case when the square minus the center, I had to write down four different formulas. Once I have written down RZ, the homotopy is easy. That's only one way to get the strong homotopy, 1 minus T double prime Z plus T double prime Z. Okay, so T double prime, because I have a T and T prime already used, so I am T double prime. So full formula for those things in terms of RZ is written down. That is not necessary. That you can check yourself. Okay. Observe that the map ST S little t, okay, pushes the square along the lines passing through 0, 2. So this is what all the time. The union of two line segments shown by the thick dotted broken lines in the image of segment T prime of 0. All that I have told you. Okay, once more, we go back. At T equal T prime, this line, the top line, becomes a broken line like this. Because this point is pushed here, and this line segment is pushed to this slanted line here. At the final stage, this entire line is broken into this line, union this line segment. So this point goes here. Okay. Any questions here? Because now I'm going to leave it here so that you verify all these formulas. And then use this one to construct more complicated examples. So next time when you come before this one, you better check this one properly and understand this homotopy very carefully. Okay, we will stop here.